Andrew here, Sterilizer Autoclave Solutions, 704-966-1650, option 3 for free tech support. Charlie981 is the error code we're going to talk about. Select mode, high limit open, unplug, replug unit. High limit thermostat open for at least 0.25 seconds during the select mode. Okay, so cause number one, this is quite the lengthy one. So we'll go one by one. Okay, maintenance not performed. Verify weekly and monthly maintenance has been performed by customer. Perform monthly maintenance if it has not been. So monthly maintenance is gonna be to clean your filters. There's two stainless steel filters in the chamber. You have to pull all the trays out. So pull them all out. Set them aside here. You're gonna wanna replace your gasket. It says yearly in the manual, but I think we all know they don't last that long. So monthly maintenance though is clean your filters, hold it up to the light, make sure you can see through it. If you can't, get a toothbrush, some speed clean, some distilled water, rinse it, scrub, repeat. There's one there. There's also one in the back center of the chamber that you can clean, also part of your weekly maintenance. The next one is sterilizer was unplugged, then plugged back in while the thermostat was still tripped. Verify if error was preceded by other error codes. Unplug unit for 60 seconds, then plug unit into to a dedicated properly rated circuit. Allow unit to cool for 30 minutes. Okay, so that's indicating that one of the high limit thermostats was tripped and then somebody unplugged it. So the high limit thermostats typically trip because of either the unit not getting enough water during the heat or during the cycle, or it's losing water throughout the cycle and pressure, whether it's from an air vent valve or a door gasket or dam gasket. So the high limit was tripped and then somebody unplugged it and replugged it. So that would just repeat the error again. So you're gonna unplug the unit from the back here or from the wall, wait 60 seconds and plug the unit back in. High limit thermostat malfunctioning. So those are under the belly of the chamber. They sit right next to the heating element. You can kind of see them from here. If it does not reset, then we can go and perform a thermostat continuity test or replace the thermostats. You'll need a multimeter to do the continuity test. You can see that in the manual. You're gonna look for loose or damaged wire connections. You're gonna check wire connections at high limit thermostat on the J5 main PC board. So down here, you're gonna check, make sure this is plugged in. You can pull it off and push it back up. Sometimes they sag down a little bit and then you'll start to get burning. You'll see a little discoloration, but the yellow and the red wire here go to your safety thermostats. Then there's a jumper that connects between the two. These things get so hot that we see a lot of times that the connectors will burn under here. So when you unplug it, you wait 60 seconds, you plug it back in, then you continually get that error. So if you want to see underneath the belly, you have to drain all the water out of the unit, and then you'll have to flip it on its side. There's a panel there, and you can look at the thermostats, and you can refer to other videos that we have to do that. But it could be loose or damaged wire, or your high limit thermostat is malfunctioning. That's where you would do the ohm test, or the multimeter test. Okay, so if the unit skips the fill mode, make sure the tray rack, tray plate are installed properly. So a lot of times what happens is when we put these in, we take them out and clean them, then we go to put them back in, we don't push them in far enough. Like it can sit here sometimes, and then even that isn't far enough back. So you kind of got to hit it with your hand, set it back in, make sure all your trays are pushed back in all the way. You don't want to hit your temp sensor for the middle too. You don't want to be as aggressive with. But you want to make sure that your tray plate is inside of the chamber. All your trays and your rack are inside the chamber. You want to make sure that the mesh filter are in place. Those are the ones that we were talking about in the beginning of the video that you got to take out and clean. Make sure those are pushed in all the way. If the office is running back-to-back cycles, if you're running consecutive cycles without completing the dry cycle, you could have issues. So always let the dry cycle finish. I would even recommend waiting 5 minutes, let everything cool down a little bit, and then start a new cycle. Your water level sensor could be malfunctioning, dirty, or foreign object touching sensor. So that's the circle disc in the back of the chamber at the bottom. I'll show you. I should have left these out, but it's okay. We'll work through it together. Pull all these out. Circle disc in the back of the chamber on the bottom, that's your water level sensor. That could be dirty, something could be stuck sitting on it. It works with ground, the ground circuit. So if there's a piece of metal sitting back there touching it, that could, you could have a problem there. Okay, so you're gonna wanna make sure that your reservoir is full. Obviously, if you have a low reservoir, that could cause some issues. If the unit completes the fill mode, we're going to check to see if the sterilizer is unlevel. Remove the trays and the rack. Verify support surfaces level. Verify water on all sides of the chamber are equal. So basically that would, you'd have to have water in here to verify that the heating element was submerged on all sides. I would probably just get a standard level and lay it across the front of the countertop and then along the back and just make sure that it is level. Then we're going to look for pressure leaks. Again, this is error code Charlie 981. Pressure leaks could come from the door gasket or the dam gasket. You want to make sure everything is fully seated all the way around here. The dam gasket sits inside of it. Also, if you have any foreign material in there, that could cause issues. There is a door ring on here also. If you bend that when you're cleaning it, you might have issues with warping of the gasket. So double check that. It could be the fill or the vent solenoid. We could put this in the service diagnostic mode and kind of dig a little bit deeper. You'll need a multimeter. We could check to make sure that power is going from the board to the given valves. Once we know that, then we can ohm out each valve, and if they're to spec, then we can at least rule out that it's not the PC board and not the solenoids, but then you'd have to get inside of the shafts of the solenoids, the housings where the piston and the plunger are, the spring, that's a little bit deeper. I'd have a service technician do that. You're going to need a tool. So that covers some of the pressure leaks. It also could be the pressure relief valve. The pressure relief valve is right here. If this is stuck open, if you previously just pulled it open and it just kind of sticks there, then you might see condensation build up in the bottom back right of the unit. You know, a lot of times these are in cabinets, so that's definitely tough to see, but you can look from the front to underneath the countertop. And if you ever see water underneath the back right hand corner, that could be your pressure relief valve is leaking because it comes down a tube and leaks down there. So it could be your pressure relief valve. I think we covered all the valves there. C981. Okay, so again, looking for pressure leaks. There's an air vent bellows back here that oftentimes corrodes. So a lot of these housings, they're made of brass, so they tend to corrode faster than stainless steel, especially the longer water sits in them. If you I would recommend cleaning these more, draining them more often than you probably are. Pressure relief valve, pressure transducer tubing. We're going to make sure that tubing is not leaking. Sometimes it leaks from here, sometimes it leaks from here, sometimes it leaks from the fitting. It could also be leaking from the where it connects to the chamber. To see that, you need a flashlight in here. You need to take the back panel off and to run an empty cycle or a cycle with the cover off can reveal a lot of little leaks here and there. So it could be that. It could be the heating element is malfunctioning. Inspect heating element. Heating element should lay flat on the bottom of the chamber. Heating element should be free of any flaking pitting. So as we get these things in for repair, like this thing is brand new, so it's nice and smooth and easy going. But when we get them in for repair, number one, this whole bottom of the chamber is discolored. Number two, you'll see like flakes and almost like a dust material at the bottom of the chamber. That's usually the heating element is corroding or pitting, or the condensation coil is doing the same. And you know, a lot of times that happens faster if you don't use distilled water. So if you're using distilled water, then that won't happen as fast. You just don't want to constantly be having water sitting here. That happens for all kinds of reasons, mainly just, you know, they're not functioning properly. There should never be any water sitting in the middle of the chamber. So it could be heating element malfunctioning. Replace that if necessary. We could do a heating element test. You got to put it in the service diagnostic mode. These are the two heating element wires here. Two ways you could do it. You can hook them up to a multimeter or touch the board terminals with a multimeter and gauge the heating element. And if you get volts, then that's probably a good thing. Or you can put an inductive ammeter on the white wire and then engage that. And then as you engage the heating element, you'll get amps here. So that's a way to test that. It could be that your PC board is malfunctioning, and that's where we'll come to those tests that, you know, when we put it in service diagnostic mode, I highly recommend you call us or another trained technician to look at that stuff. Could be your, like I said, your PC board malfunctioning. And last but not least, which is the easiest thing that the end user could do, and I might have said this already, it's kind of a long video, but it could be that your sterilizer was overloaded. You had too much instruments in here, and I see that especially with an M9. The M9s, they're just not big enough. They're 9-inch chamber by 14-inch in the back, and you stuff a lot of instruments back in there, and they just fail. So overloaded would be the easiest remedy. So check the size of the load, refer to the user guide, reduce load size. So if you like this video, please share it, like it. For more videos, please subscribe to our channel, and have a great day.